hard to come back. It brings back hard memories.
Locally, Pearl Harbor survivors are also telling their stories, where they were, what they saw, what they did when the first bombs hit. That's how they marked this anniversary in Mission, Kansas. KMBC 9's Maria Antonia shows us how one man relives the history a lot more than once a year.
Jack Carson is one of four Pearl Harbor survivors here. He wouldn't miss a gathering like this one, in part because he feels he still has a mission to carry out.
So that was the true band.
To share his story with others.
Well, I was laying in bed and I heard all this loud noise, and I thought that it was Pearl Harbor having, you know, practice.
Until the 88-year-old saw this view from the wooden barracks at Hickam Field where he was when the enemy flew overhead.
When I saw the big red ball on the tail, I realized immediately that we were under attack ourselves.
Carson was 18.
So that's the story of my life.
The same age as Hannah, who sat in the first row today listening to the stories Carson feels people should hear, especially young people, and Hannah agrees.
And I think it's important that we as this younger generation are able to know what happened, because we have a tendency, America forgets.
We don't necessarily give speeches, we just sit down and discuss Pearl Harbor and the world after Pearl Harbor.
Carson made it a point to mention to us that of the four survivors here, he is the youngest, with a story that will never get too old for him to share. In Mission, Maria Antonia, KMBC 9 News.
Maria, thank you. Carson is continuing to share his Pearl Harbor stories. He's scheduled to talk to seventh graders at a local middle school tomorrow.